What is going on, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to take a look at the all-new 2021 Prizm Football Mega Box from Panini. This is probably going to be the Walmart version or the MJ Holdings version. They typically make them square for them. And yeah, they aren't released on Walmart's website or out in the wild yet, not at least that I know of. I know some LCSs have been getting these, which is where I got one of these. Went for $75, which is slightly above normal, so it's not too crazy. I think the blasters were probably crazier than this. If you haven't seen those, check out the video in the description down below. Really, really clean, cool looking lasers if you want to check those out. But really looking forward to this one. And yeah, I don't know what else to say. I'll show you guys the box in a sec. So let's jump right into it, guys. If you enjoy this kind of content and want to see more, drop a like down below and consider subscribing. It really helps out the channel and really helps us grow. And we do have some giveaways here and there every now and then on the channel. We have soccer, basketball content mainly. So let's get all the packs out. So you're getting 40 cards total. So I'm guessing it's 4 cards per pack, 10 packs per box. And you're expected to get 3 silver prisms per box, which is kind of wild. 2 mega box exclusive green pulsars. So from what we've seen from the blasters, it said 2 exclusive like blaster parallels, but then we got more of them. So I guess we can get 2 rookies plus a few more green pulsar prisms. So here's what you can expect for the whole thing. The black and red checkers are gonna be the more sought after ones because they're more rare than your typical green pulsars and silvers and all that stuff. But you are expected to get a mem card from one of these boxes. From what I've seen, the target version mega box, which is gonna be the like more rectangle shape, you can get an auto or mem. Unfortunately, no auto from this one, which is kind of disappointing, but I don't know what goes behind the reasoning for why they do this at Panini. So let's get right into it, guys. Hopefully we get some nice cards, nice parallels, and maybe a really, really nice mem. Didn't get so lucky with the blasters, but it was, I guess, maybe average or slightly below average, depending on how you look at it. Got some nice rookies, but here we go with the mega box, starting off with Van Jefferson. Our first rookie here is, I don't know if he's in pain or what, but Asante Samuel Jr. And our first green pulsar is going to be Neil Hunter. Big fan of the pulsar patterns. I don't know what teams this is really going to go best with. What do you guys think? I mean, it's a really, really tough color match for a lot of team colors. But let me set this one aside over here. And pack number 2. All right, getting all the bases out of the way. And Tyson Campbell's our second rookie. And Ja'Marr Chase, the second emergent exact card that we pulled from the blasters, actually. Really wish this was a parallel. Would be really, really sick if we could pull that. I'll just add him to the rookie pile. But yeah, it's been a long, nice weekend. I don't know about you guys, but I was really actually looking forward to the Warriors and Celtics game, which was actually going on like right before I made this video. Teylon Wallace, our first Ravens rookie, green pulsar. We put this one over here. We'll do a recap at the end. But yeah, sorry to talk about basketball during a football rip, but yeah, it was a pretty intense game. Really rooting for Golden State to win. Big fan of Jason Tatum, but you know, I think Steph Curry deserves it way more. Kelvin Joseph. So these rookies are so far really, really rough. Our third green pulsar. As you guys may have heard, the set size increased to 440 from 400, which is another thing to make chasing any player's cards, I guess, way harder than usual. Sam Ehlinger, rookie base. And our first silver is gonna be a rookie Ambry Thomas. Not familiar with this guy, but it is our first silver. Hopefully the next 3 silvers are going to be rookies, and we're still waiting on our second green pulsar rookie, and one of those packs is going to have a mem, if not a redemption maybe. CEH, Khalil Herbert, and Leonard Floyd for the Rams, a green pulsar. So far we've pulled four greens. I'm guessing there's gonna be six total. One more rookie and one more vet. Here's our next green at the end. Bobby Wagner, Vaughn Miller, Greg Rousseau. Man, every single product I open, I get at least one of his cards. And who's this gonna be? It's just a vet, Charles Woodson. Again, just very, very pleasing to look at these green pulsars. This is a really thick pack, so it's definitely our mem. Let's keep it to the end, because why not? And here we go, Zach Cunningham. Oh man, that kid reporter card at the end always gets me. I always feel like it's, ooh, LaDainian Tomlinson. Talk about throwbacks, man. This is one of the guys who really got me into like running backs, and he is a legend indeed. Seth Williams, next base rookie, and our first brilliance look from retail, Devontae Adams. Really, really digging the look of this card. I'm a big fan of brilliance cards. I mean, even from last year's set, it looked really nice. I think it's just the black adds like some sort of prestige to the card. So really liking this one. I'm gonna put it, don't know, with the silver, I guess. Why not? But two last packs. And if you guys Google, or not Google, if you guys search on YouTube, I guess it's the same thing in the end, for like some crazy pulls from this year's Prism, it's mainly gonna be from hobby. You're gonna see a lot of one of ones pulled of like Mac Jones and Tom Brady, Kenneth Gainwell. Not a one of one of him, but here's our Seth Williams green pulsar rookie. Unfortunately, we got a base of him and a green pulsar. So really not a big fan of this box, as you guys can tell. Sorry, and the last one of one that was pulled among other rookies and players was Patty Mahomes. So here's Mike Evans for the Bucks. Is the lighting? Yeah, okay, I can't really tell. I feel like it's like darker than usual, but it might just be my phone screen. Tylan Wallace. And if you're looking for any player to get a mem for, it is Najee Harris indeed. I'm a fan of this guy. And, oh, it's a green pulsar. It's not just any mem. I didn't know these had to be green. So, I mean, this portion is obviously like regular color. I don't know if it's the color. It has to be a green pulsar. So, rookie Najee Harris. All right, saving grace for the box. Enclosed authentic memorabilia is not from any specific game or event. It's very, very common for Panini to do this for retail products, unfortunately. The game worn stuff is always saved for like hobby or like higher priced products. But there it is. Let's give it a good little scratch. But all right, yeah, I was getting very, very disappointed with that box. So at least we got something nice out of it. Christian Wilkins is gonna be our second silver. Let me just bring the box back on. I don't think we got three silvers. It says find three silver prisms per box on average. I mean, that on average is what makes it what it is. So that's understandable. I don't have a thick sleeve for this guy. So just one more look, Najee Harris. I'm happy. I don't know if you guys would be happy about this, but I like collecting Najee Harris's cards. So for the Steelers, and let's do a recap for the green pulsars. So here's our first rookie green pulsar. One out of the two that is promised by the box. And then here are all the remaining green pulsars. Our second rookie is right here. And of course, these are not numbered. You cannot get numbered cards from these boxes. And here's our vet silver. Got our brilliance. Really, really digging the look of this card. And Ambry Thomas, our rookie silver. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Honestly, if you're gonna try to choose between a square mega box or the rectangle mega box, I haven't even ripped a rectangle one, and I can tell you that just because it has a chance for an auto, just go for that one. They're probably gonna be priced the same way. It's just one company has a more exclusive, I don't know, like set or whatever, like specific product in this. So if you want to wait for the rectangle one, I'd recommend that. But if you're trying to maybe, I don't know, just for the sake of variety, try this one out, then go ahead. But honestly, probably better off saving your money for the other version of the Mega Box. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Stick around for more content and giveaways. And yeah, as always, we'll see you in the next one.